Could it be four?
Okay. To change.
Dear Brian, ladies and gentlemen, what I'm going to do with you is going from stupid to smart energy systems. It's quite a journey. And the more recent step are flexibility markets, peer-to-peer, and energy communities. It comes from yesterday. The world we are entering in is smarter. You remember Connolly? Connolly saying, wow, the energy system is stupid, was stupid. Now it's coming smart. Even if we do it one step at a time, that's a major change. But Connolly is young. I am not. I was born in another world more than 60 years ago. That's me. In my father's shop, it was existing. Electricity was not understood at all. It was managed by a vertically integrated utility, even in France only one, state monopoly. It was entering the fridge, and you see that sometimes the meat was not entering the fridge because electricity was too expensive. But what you see is that what Connolly did call stupid energy system was not even existing. We weren't stupid yet. How did we become stupid before being smart? But that's what we are going to look at. First, we had to become stupid. So we were still working, the industry was still working in a vertically supply hierarchy, but based on markets and system operators, what we call B2B, business to business, B2C, business to consumers. And then only we did get something smarter. How? By creating a demand loop. Demand loop invented, we may say, by aggregators, then used for flexibility markets. We may call them C2B, consumer to business, or we may call them C2SO, consumer to system operators. And we can do even more. We can become fully smart by fully activating demand, which means C2PL, consumer to platform, peer-to-peer, and also, at this stage, welcoming communities. I will explain why. But we may do if energy regulators are okay. Are they okay? Do energy regulators join this smart wave? We will look at the case of Ofgem. Let's go. First, to become stupid. How did we become stupid? By opening wholesale markets. What do wholesale markets? They do only one thing. They rank generating plants in a day-ahead merit order. So they do the same thing like the integrated utility before, but they do it with open bids. And then, when we have the merit order, we need the TSO, because the TSO manages the system and its flows accordingly, according to the ranking, but by adding grid congestion constraints and central balancing needs. So the TSO plays a very active role that market cannot do. Notice that all this electricity system is managed business to business. Why? Because it is managed within the supply central hierarchy. We have still a central hierarchy. Nothing is decentralized, and demand is mute. Then we got retail markets, but let's be frank. Retail markets are only retailing the wholesale supply hierarchy. The hierarchy does not move. We call it B2C, business to consumer. What it does? The market price and central merit order we have seen in the wholesale market, plus the system congestion and the system central balancing, all this package is made for retail size units. That's a packaging which is retail, not the hierarchy of the system. This is made via new digitalization tools as smart metering, smart grids, balancing responsible parties, etc. Many things to be added to the opening of the wholesale markets, but still within a central hierarchy. There's new. What is new? Demand loop. First, via aggregators. What do aggregators? They create something new, a C2B, consumer to business loop, between retail size units and wholesale. They do it by packaging demand activation as a wholesale tradable product. If you package demand, it can be activated and sold in the wholesale market. These new intermediaries, the aggregators, aggregate retail via new digitalization tools, roughly digital control of retail size consumption unit, which was not made before. And then TSOs and DSOs. TSO stands for transmission system operators, DSO for distribution system operators. They can come and they can push the consumer to business one step ahead, consumer to system operator. You remember, aggregators were packaging demand activation for the wholesale market. System operators, TSO, DSO, are packaging demand activation for their own grid congestion and balancing needs, for the actual management of flows. So demand activation enters directly the core of the real flows. That's why it's a big new step. They do it combining two kinds of tools, platform-like tools to trade with consumption units, to activate consumption units, but also system operator IT, system operator control truths to guarantee system reliability. Because the consumption units have to deliver, we have to track the delivery. Now, the last big step, according to my knowledge, peer-to-peer and communities. Why is it one more step? You remember, aggregators, they are packaging demand activation for wholesale market. System operators, they are packaging demand activation for system and grid needs. C2, system operator. But if the system operators are using platforms, they are doing consumer to platforms. This is something more. Why? What is a platform? A platform is a digital space which provides product definition, trade partner search, partner matching, delivery between the partners, settlement between the partners. A platform delivers a lot. As soon as we create platforms, we create a new universe of trade and of industry. A platform can then provide double activation. The platform can activate small consumers, or consumers, being not small, but only consumers, and small producers, of new producers, being not very big. They activate both. That's why we use a new term, peer-to-peer. Peer-to-peer, now it's clear, simple, it's a double activation via appropriate digital tools. If both demand and supply have to be activated, it is because they are both small. They are not having enough size. They are not having enough professional skills to trade in four professional markets, like business to business or business to consumers. This double activation, you know, with another word, sharing economy. Sharing economy is double activation. Uber, Airbnb, or others. You can take the one you like. If you hate Uber, take another one. And double activation eliminates the need of intermediary like aggregators. Aggregators being consumer to business. Double activation can work either with platforms, and you see that platforms are new intermediaries. They do not sell, they do not buy, they let the others do. So they are different from aggregators. Or even you can have direct trade as blockchains in clubs, peer to block to peer. You do not need a platform. The platform is now automatic. Blockchain is an automatic platform. The platform is not a platform. The two peer can be okay to use blockchain with no platform at all. Communities, what are they? Extremely easy to understand now. We have seen that peer-to-peer is double activation of individual units in an agdot market frame, being platform of blockchain. Communities. Communities are voluntary association of individual units. They associate in a collective decision-making unit. They take decisions together. This association breaks the two small size. It breaks the too little expectations that the individuals have as constraints. The voluntary association permits collective supply, collective investment, collective asset operation, collective demand management, many things individuals cannot do alone. I know that being in a community is very demanding. One Swiss engineer I had a wonderful dinner with, and two glasses of wine each, told me, oh, Jean-Michel, okay, but community, I have so many things to do in my life, I have no time for this. Okay, but you can enter in a loose community only. What is a loose community? Asset fleet management. Today or tomorrow, individuals will have many management options. Open by what? Open by smart devices, smart homes, smart buildings, Internet of Things. Many, many options will come. It could be tempting to be only de facto community, to be only loose community of users, of asset fleets managed by professionals. Think electrical car fleet, 10,000 cars managed by the same central professional charging application. It does exist already, by the way. Even the French Renault is doing it. Huh? Zero net consumption buildings. What is a zero net consumption building, California, EU to come? But they are fully autonomous mini-grid systems. They are fully managed as a portfolio of assets or a collection of assets. But will energy regulators push it or block it? CEER, the European Association of Energy Regulators. They are my closest friends, but I am not okay every day with them. Sometimes I'm taking my coffee alone. As the 25th of June, their report on peer-to-peer and communities. What does say the report? We are not at ease with peer-to-peer and communities, you know, because both are disruptive of existing wholesale market, correct. Existing central system operation, correct. Existing grid universal access, correct. Peer-to-peer and communities are not universal. Existing consumer protection, correct. Peer-to-peer and communities won't work with this existing protection, being a protection conceived vis-à-vis big companies. But CEER is not at ease, but CEER is not the end of the world. The end of the world is coming. Brexit, no off jam. The British regulator did issue an analysis, research analysis of flexibility platforms in electricity market. Look at the fact that flexibility is a market, platform is a market. So two things are new. Flexibility becomes a market, platforms become market. Then what do they say? I will sing the French hymn. Allons enfants de la patrie, le jour de gloire est arrivé. That's lovely what they say. They fully acknowledge that flexibility issue is a real entry, is a new interactive electricity system where users' assets activation, be they consumer or prosumer, is key. Reread it. a new interactive electricity system where users' assets activation is key. It's not the electricity system with wholesale market and transmission system operator opened 30 years ago. It's totally new. And they say also that platforms are digital tools opening markets to peer-to-peer. So it's favorable. They have a tone different from the European report of their colleagues. And now the proof. It's coming from the report. You have six basic tasks for flexibility platforms. The upper three, coordination, flexibility, procurement, dispatch and control, are more with the system. But even for these three, the British regulator is suggesting that coordination and flexibility procurement can be provided by a new type of company if this company could guarantee the seriousness of the operation, because it's about reliability. They even say that dispatch and control ultimately can also be delivered by a new type of company, being not distribution grid, being not transmission grid. Oh, and the three others, both that platform, analytics and feedbacks, market services, settlement, they are platforms, so they can already be delivered by platforms cooperating with DSO, TSO. So even a flexibility platform in the UK is already a mix between platform tasks and system tasks. That's fantastic. It's not all, and it's better for you to be seated. What I will show you, I couldn't believe, because this report is 2nd of September. It's not yet 2 weeks old. Woof. The upper part, DNO. DNO is a distribution system operator. ESO. ESO is a British TSO. Balancing market is a part of the centrally managed wholesale market. Suppliers, they are the suppliers we know. All the rest is new. On the left-hand side, we'll start from the right. DER. Renewable producers, many of them prosumers in Germany or Australia. The left-hand side, P2P. There is plenty of roles to peer-to-peer to provide flexibility to the system. In the middle, aggregator. And then something else, OEM. Boom, boom. What does it mean, OEM? It's the OEM of international economics, original equipment manufacturers. What does it mean? Electrical car fleets. Smart fridges, smart heaters, all these devices consuming electricity, many of them will become smart because the manufacturer will create them smart. Then the manufacturer will create a new world when we can manage fleets of assets, fleets of devices, because they are smart and they will provide directly flexibility to the system. It's personally, I do not say OEM platform, I call it fleets of assets. But that's the same. It is saying that fridges, heaters, cars will deliver flexibility to the system. That's exactly what we can call an interactive electricity system or a smart electricity system, according to Connolly. I will not finish to Connolly. I will finish with the US Council for US Council GridWise, or Wise Grid. 4 years ago, they were saying, we are going to a fully new electricity system, being the transactive energy system. It starts on the left-hand side, building and home, doing self-optimization. After that, we will go to campus self-optimization with microgrids. After that, we will create virtual power plants interconnected with grids and markets. And at the end, we will have enormous utility-scale microgrid fully integrated with local balancing markets. It has not been implemented. They were thinking 2020, everything will work. It's delayed, obviously, 10 years more. But everything they say, this bunch of American engineers, is coming, which is incredible. And now acknowledged by the UK regulator. So the Danish regulator should look at it. Next, by a very obvious, with sector coupling, all district heating will enter electricity indirective system as a smart flexibility resource, what Brian is advocating since several years, and why I know Brian because of this. And they are already managed by energy communities, and you have a law protecting energy communities at European level, and each country can enrich the law. So push for it. District heating should be recognized as a full part of the electricity system via sector coupling. If you want to get more, very easy, you go to Front School of Regulation website, you follow our weekly topic of the month. What is the topic this month? This month, flexibility mechanisms, consumer data management, electromobility, peer-to-peer trade, presented by our author, Valerie Reif from Austria. That's it. Thank you.